Here we go. That's it's like the last actual phone in the world.
Nice. Nice.
I don't even know what this is supposed to mean. Hi, I'm Burke Holland.
I'm Jasmine Greenaway.
And this is 5 reasons that JavaScript developers should even care about .NET Core. Thing number one, .NET Core is cross-platform. So when we say .NET is cross-platform, does that mean that it works on all versions of Windows? What do we mean by cross-platform, really?
Well, not only all versions of Windows, but also Linux and Mac. And actually, also on IoT devices, believe it or not.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. So you could pretty much program your fridge with .NET Core if you have one of those little Samsung, whatever, Tizen things. I forget what they're called.
Yeah, I think it's a Tizen. It's a Tizen fridge. It's a screen on your fridge where you can, like, see the weather, play video games.
Yeah.
But does anybody, I don't know why anybody would ever do that.
Right?
If you have a smart fridge, what's wrong with you?
Right.
But you could run .NET Core on your fridge.
Yes, absolutely.
Interesting. Yeah. Nice. Can I run it on this iPad?
Not today, but maybe one day. Who knows?
Hey, listen, anything is possible.
Anything is absolutely possible,
wow.
For sure.
Thing number two, when you're building a single page application, it's easy to use .NET Core for a backend. So I think it goes without saying, although a lot of times we don't say it, single page applications kind of have to have a backend. And a lot of JavaScript developers do something else besides JavaScript. A lot of them do Java or they do .NET. So .NET Core is a very, very attractive option, or could be an attractive option, for building backends for your single page application.
Yeah, absolutely. So you can use the .NET Core's web API, and it's super easy to get started. There's so many templates. Actually, in fact, there's templates on working with the web API and with the front end. So for example, if you're a fan of the Angular command line and you want to work with that independently with web API, you can absolutely do that and, like, you know, work on your front end, work on your back end. And in fact, .NET or the .NET team has actually added libraries to make this super easy, so you can do things like hot reloading and not have to, or hot module replacement.
Save and it automatically recompiles, so you don't have to stop and restart again to see the changes.
Exactly.
Also, as a last final detail, approximately 0 JavaScript developers also write COBOL. I don't know if you know that.
Oh.
That's a scientific statistic. I looked it up.
Oh, really?
Well, there may be one or two. If you're out there and you write COBOL and you also write JavaScript, hit us up and let us know. We'll send you something.
Right? Yeah. Huh.
Thing number three, you can get started with .NET Core with only the command line. Now, I'm going to be honest, that's a little weird for me. I have a history with .NET, and I do believe you also need, like, 76 gigabytes of Visual Studio. Is that not the case?
So, number one, Visual Studio is actually not that large.
Okay, 75 gigabytes. I'm embellishing. I apologize. It's so, not. It's like 4 or 3, 4 or something. I don't know. It's actually smaller than it was back in 2015 when I used to use it.
Yeah, it's much smaller. And you may need an IDE to get started, or IDE or text editor to get started. You could literally just download it and then do .NET run, .NET new to create a new project, .NET start, and you have your own .NET project ready to go, ready
just
to
right there modify. On the terminal.
Yes.
What about Visual Studio Code? Some people may know I love Visual Studio Code. I also love my light editor theme. Don't at me. There's nothing wrong with a light editor theme. So for those of us using Visual Studio Code, which is a lot of folks, are there any tools or extensions that would make that easier?
Yes, OmniSharp. OmniSharp will take care of any references and things like that you might be missing in your library, any syntax issues. OmniSharp is like your one-stop shop for all that with .NET.
So check out the OmniSharp extension. We'll put a link in the show notes to that extension for you. So go ahead and check that out if you're interested in doing .NET Core inside of Visual Studio Code. Excellent. Thing number four. .NET Core is fast, and I know everybody says that, but I think that maybe we should talk about just how fast it is. So can you give us an example here so we're not just saying it's fast?
Yes, so my favorite example is Raygun. So Raygun, they are this analytics company that does a lot of like crash reports and things like that on mobile and web apps. And they did a case study where they improved switching to .NET Core improved their throughput from 1,000 requests per second to 20,000 requests per second.
20x performance improvement?
2,000% increase, throughput increase, which is amazing.
Increase over what? What were they using before?
They were using Node, believe it or not. And so... we actually have benchmarks that report every month or so about like how fast it is. And you know, the reason why .NET Core is so fast is that in the past we had, you know, .NET was, as we know, was only for Windows.
Right.
And now that we have a lot of .NET had a lot of libraries that were only like Windows specific. And now, so getting rid of all of those libraries and improving these performances and like improving like performances like on things like collections and things like that has made .NET super .NET Core super fast. And believe it or not, a lot of these improvements came from outside in the community.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Which brings us to our next thing.
Yes.
Thing number five, .NET Core is open source, which, cool story, bro. Everything is open source these days. What's in it for me as a JavaScript developer? Why do I care?
So yes, .NET's open source, and the nice thing about that is you get full transparency. You get interaction with the actual team that's working on .NET Core, and you also get the roadmaps. You can see the roadmap. You can see what's happening, what's coming up, and also have input. So we have a lot of contributors who come in and just, you know, add these like new improvements and updates and ideas and make .NET for them, because that's what it really is. It's about reaching out to developers, and you know, open source is just a window to make this language ours.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's so great. And one of the things that I love about open source, which I think you hit on, is the contributions. I remember when someone from in the community added basically JSON support for .NET with NewtonSoft.
Yeah.
And I remember that. And you had this third-party package, which eventually just became, you know, they were just shipping it.
Yes.
So it's so cool that people can now add this stuff
yes.
directly to the framework. And I also think that it's been around for so long that they've had so much time to iterate to make it super fast. So
yes.
they've already hit all of the roadblocks and had all the hard issues and figured out and gotten around them. There's a lot of advantage in using something that's extremely mature, a very mature framework. A lot of advantages to that.
Yes, yeah. I agree.
As a footnote, I used to be a .NET developer. I was never very good. I only did it for a short amount of time. But what I noticed was that C# and JavaScript are actually quite similar, and it was easy for me to make the jump. So if you are a JavaScript developer, one of the advantages to looking into C# is that it's going to feel very familiar. And so if you're thinking, I can only do Node or I can only do JavaScript, you should look into C# a little bit and see if it might be for you. And we'll leave some links for you in the resources below where you can get started with that. I'm Burke Collins.
I'm Jasmine Greenaway.
And now you know five reasons why JavaScript developers should even care about .NET Core.